The elder statesman of rock poetry delivers his final testament with You Want It Darker. That's coming up next on JO42 Reviews. There's a haunting aura to certain final albums. When an artist knows in their heart that this will be the summation of their life's work, they tend to take on a uniquely contemplative tone. Sometimes it's bittersweet, as in Warren Zevon's final farewell on 2003's The Wind, or haunting and spectral like David Bowie's Black Star. A personal favorite of mine is Queen's Innuendo, where Freddie Mercury forced to lay down with an oxygen mask between takes as he suffered end-stage AIDS, delivers his most scorching, raw, magnificently human vocal performance in the band's already stunning catalog. When master wordsmith Leonard Cohen released You Want It Darker, many ardent fans, myself included, feared that Cohen was saying goodbye. Despite assuring his audiences that he intended to live to 120, Cohen had in fact been battling cancer, and he passed away suddenly just a few short weeks later at the age of 82. Given that momentous passing, the album takes on a whole new magnitude. Leonard Cohen is one of those songwriters like Prince or Peter Gabriel or Lou Reed or Donald Fagen, where a song is not just a song, it is a window into the world of their mind. It is a place that we inhabit with them for a few minutes that they are singing, and the world can only truly be inhabited when they are the ones doing the singing. In that world, Leonard Cohen is a vast, sprawling specter across the modern music landscape. He is at once immediate and charming, but also brooding and mysterious. He finds spirituality and sexual gratification, but does so with a quiet dignity that allows him to plumb the depths of erotic intrigue with elegance and poise. He views love and relationships with the kind of detached humor one finds in a Buddhist monk, which is not surprising considering that he was a Buddhist monk. His flair for subtlety allows him to find gorgeous shades of nuance in the realms of love we all inhabit. Songs like Dance Me to the End of Love showcase Cohen's overarching fascination with the entire arc of relationships. He isn't just entranced by the meeting, the sex, heartfelt sentiment, or the painful breakup as most poets would be. Instead, Cohen holds court over the entire process and cherishes every moment of it. Consider this lyric from Hallelujah, widely considered to be Cohen's signature song. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to your kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips, she drew the hallelujah. Here we see Cohen capturing the fulfillment a man finds in committing himself to a long-term relationship by equating it to submitting oneself before God. The thought of a woman cutting a man's hair is generally used to suggest that he has been pussy-whipped, but here Cohen suggests that such a surrender is just a prelude to the higher echelons of enlightenment to be found in the bonds of matrimony. That Cohen can weave such texture and depth into a single stanza shows that he is a poet par excellence. Then there's the about face that is I'm Your Man, where Cohen presents as the stone-cold pimp that responds to his lady's attempts to shake his resolve by declaring his willingness to let her slip away, and that it won't lower his cheerful mood if she does, that no matter how much he wants to grovel for her to come back, he knows that it's futile, so he chooses happiness instead. These are the many layers of dissection that Cohen brings to all facets of human existence. There is never a single emotion or a single concept. Heartbreak and true love are always seen through the same prism in pursuit of greater enlightenment. That dichotomy resonates throughout You Want It Darker. The title track carries the cool detachment of much of Cohen's work. He is known for his dark, mysterious lyrics, and the words, "You Want It Darker, We Kill the Flame," seems to suggest his final thoughts to his audience, that he has gone to the darkest depths possible, and he can only go one step further, death itself. The refrain, "I'm ready, Lord," drives this home. Musically, the album is delivered with the kind of fragile tone indicative of latter period Cohen. Gone are the disco dance floor grooves of First We Take Manhattan or the country-infused strut of Closing Time, to be replaced with soft, sparse instrumentation over which Cohen's voice hovers just shy of a toneless whisper. He's done belting it out, this is an album that sounds like it was recorded on a deathbed surrounded by candles as a nurse clad in holy robes waits for the EKG to flatline. The music that dances around Cohen's gentle baritone evokes waves of the kind of Parisian lounge music that has always underlined Cohen's warmer moments, but now tempered with a cool sorrow. Echoing across the hallowed chapel of Cohen's final words are strains of interwoven guitar, including classical passages by his own son Adam. Drums from Brian McLeod lack the standard tribal intensity of rock rhythm and instead serve as a gently pulsating reminder of our primary focal point. The second track, Treaty, finds Cohen attempting to make peace with what would seem to be his agnostic, speculative relationship with God. On the Level sees that literal spirituality once again turning metaphorical as Cohen laments a love he turned away. Truly, this album sees the death of a ladies' man. Leaving the Table gives us Cohen's ultimate finger in the air to the concept of death. He's cashing in his chips and walking out of this existence with the same black trench coat and sunglasses chill that he lived it. It's the final destination, and he's totally unfazed. For all the limitless analysis that Leonard Cohen's work offers, there is truly no way to summarize his career, his legacy, his life, and his death. With You Want It Darker, he's taken the words out of our mouths once and for all. Thumbs up. If you enjoyed this commentary, please help me continue to bring you more content by making a donation to patreon.com/jordanowen42. Your contribution will help me turn this channel into a hub of libertarian pop culture discussion and current events commentary. Thank you for listening, and as always, please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already.